हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू जीएस पॉडकास्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डीप ओशन मिशन। एज ऑफ नाउ अराउंड 95% ऑफ द डीप ओशन रिमेन्स अनएक्सप्लोर्ड एंड इन द केस ऑफ इंडिया द कंट्री इज सराउंडेड बाय ओशन ऑन द थ्री साइड्स एंड हैज अराउंड 30% ऑफ इट्स पॉपुलेशन लिविंग इन द कोस्टल एरियाज। देयरफॉर द ओशन इज अ मेजर इकोनॉमिक फैक्टर दैट सपोर्ट फिशरीज, एक्वाकल्चर, लाइवलीहुड, टूरिज्म एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट द ब्लू ट्रेड और ब्लू इकॉनमी। एंड टू सपोर्ट दिस मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ साइंसेज हैज अप्रूव्ड द प्रपोजल ऑफ डीप ओशन मिशन विद अ व्यू टू एक्सप्लोर डीप ओशन फॉर द रिसोर्सेज एंड डेवलप डीप सी टेक्नोलॉजीज फॉर सस्टेनेबल यूज ऑफ सच रिसोर्सेज। सो वी विल डिस्कस द कोर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ डीप ओशन मिशन इन डिटेल, बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स सी वॉट आर द टॉपिक्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस सेक्शन। So first one is, what is deep sea mining and what kind of minerals are present in seabed? Second one, what are the highlights of India's deep ocean mission? Third one, what are the environmental challenges and concerns involved in deep sea mining? And finally, we will discuss some of the measures to limit the environmental impact of mining activities. So let's begin. So let's understand what is deep sea mining. So it is a term applied to process and technologies designed to collect metal rich resources from the deep sea floor. And there are mainly three types of seabed mineral resources that are of interest to the mining companies, which are polymetallic nodules, polymetallic sulfides and cobalt crust. So here polymetallic nodules occurs throughout the ocean and are found lying on the seafloor in the deepest part of the ocean. And they are often partially buried in the form of fine grain sediments. And these polymetallic nodules contain metals such as manganese, iron, copper, nickel, cobalt, lead, zinc, etc. Now let's see polymetallic sulfide, which are also known as seafloor massive sulfides, that are rich in copper, iron, zinc, silver and gold. And third one is cobalt crust, and it can be found in the depth of seafloor, and they are formed through the precipitation of minerals from the seawater, and they contain iron, manganese, nickel, cobalt and various rare metals, including some of the rare earth metals. So these are some kind of minerals that are formed in deep seabed. Now let's move on to understand what are the highlights of India's deep ocean mission. Now we see in the context of India, the deep ocean mission is expected to explore the deep ocean for resources and at the same time to develop deep sea technologies that can be used for sustainable use of ocean resources. So let's analyze the six major component of deep ocean mission. Here first one is Ocean Climate Change Advisory Services. Under this mission, the government will work on the development model upon the observation that will provide future projection of important climate variables. This particular component will be supporting the blue economy for the country. Second component is technologies for deep sea mining and manned submersible. This component is focused on developing a manned submersible that will able to carry three people to 6,000 meters in the ocean. Also, scientific sensors can be taken for an integrated mining system in order to conduct the exploration services. Now, the third component is conducting deep ocean survey and exploration. Here the Indian government is trying to explore as well as identify potential sites that have multi-metal hydrothermal sulfides mineralization within the Indian Ocean mid-oceanic reserves by the help of survey and the exploration. Now let's see the fourth component, which is technological innovation for exploration and conservation of deep sea biodiversity. So under this component, the focus of the government will be respecting of deep sea flora and fauna, and also to study how utilization of the deep sea can be sustainable. Now, fifth component is energy and fresh water from the ocean. The aim under this component will be studying the detailed engineering design for offshore ocean thermal energy convergence, which also help in desalination plant. Finally, sixth component, that is advanced marine station for ocean biology. So this component will translate research into industrial application and product development through the on-site incubator facilities. So these are some of the highlights of India's deep ocean mission. Now let's move on to understand what are the environmental concerns associated with the deep sea mining. So first one is the disturbance of the sea floor. The scraping of the ocean floor by machines can alter or destroy deep sea habitats, leading to the loss of species and fragmentation or loss of ecosystem structure and functions. Second one is concern to the endemic species. Many species living in the deep sea are endemic, meaning they do not occur anywhere else on the planet. And physical disturbance in just one mining site can possibly out an entire species. So this is one of the biggest potential impact from deep sea mining. Now the third one is sediment plumes. Some form of deep sea mining sometimes stir up fine sediments consisting of silt, clay and the remains of microorganism, which creates plumes of suspended particles which may choke animals or affect how they feed. Now the fourth one is pollution. Species such as whales, tuna and sharks could be affected by noise, vibrations and light pollutions caused by the mining equipment and surface vessels. There is also the risk of accidents like leaks and spills of fuel that could endanger the deep sea life. So these are some of the environmental concerns associated with the deep mining. Now let's see what are the steps that can be taken to limit the environmental impact of the mining activities. First one is baseline studies. So a comprehensive baseline studies are needed to understand what kind of species live in the deep sea and how they could be affected by the mining activities. For this, more funds are needed for training and educational programs focused on improving our understanding of the deep sea. Second one is mitigation. So current technologies may not be sufficient to avoid serious and lasting harm to the environment, include loss of biodiversity. So mining operation strategies will need to prioritize the mitigation steps to avoid environmental concerns. This needs to include establishing protected areas network to keep large part of the seabed undisturbed as well as stringent, and precautionary controls on the permissible extent and duration of the mining operation, which help in minimizing impact of deep sea mining. And other things that we can do is like improving mining equipment to reduce seafloor disturbance. So these are some of the mitigation measures. Now let's see the third one, which is enhanced regulation. The International Seabed Authority is mandated under the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea to organize, regulate and control all mineral related activities in the international seabed area for the benefit of the mankind as a whole. So International Seabed Authority has the duty to ensure effective protection of the marine environment from harmful effects that may arise from deep sea mining related activities. Now next step is circular economy. The repair, recycling and reuse of products should be encouraged to help reduce the demand for the raw material from the deep sea. hence reducing the mining activities in the seabed. So that's all about deep sea mining. Now let's see a question that has been asked in CSE prelims this year. The question is, consider the following statements. Here three statements are given. So let's start analyzing with the statement number one. The Global Ocean Commission was an international initiative between 2013 and 2016 to raise awareness and to promote actions to address the degradation of the ocean and to help restore it to full health and productivity. And here license for the seabed exploration and mining in international water are granted by the International Seabed Authority, not the Global Ocean Commission. So here statement one is incorrect. Now let's see statement number two. India has been exploring deep sea for minerals since 1981, and in 2017, India's exclusive rights to explore polymetallic nodules from seabed in the Central Indian Ocean Basin have been excluded by 5 years. So yes, we can say that India has received licenses for seabed mineral exploration in international waters. So here statement two is correct one. Now let's see statement number third. As we have discussed, the deep seabed contains potential resources for rare earth elements like polymetallic nodules, which typically contains manganese, nickel, copper, cobalt and rare earth minerals, including polymetallic sulfide and cobalt crust. So here statement third is also correct. So the correct answer for this question is option number B. That is statement 2 and 3 are correct. So that's all for today. Now if you have any doubt or suggestions regarding this topic, you can write it in the comment section. Also, if you need PDF for the same, you can download it from the link given in the description box below. And stay tuned with us for such more interesting GS topics. Till then, thank you everyone and have a nice day.